Hello guys, this is Professor DK and welcome to another episode of the Simple Login App using the database series. So in the last video, we completed the database section of Firebase. So if you haven't watched that, make sure you watch that. The link is in the description below. So today we'll be dealing with a new section of Firebase called storage. Alright, so the functionalities of storage and the database are pretty much the same. Only thing is that they deal with different kinds of data. So in today's video, what we'll do is we'll be implementing an onClick listener on the image view, right? So we had created this image view in our activity registration.xml layout. So before we begin, if you have any other tabs open, so you can just go ahead and close them out. You will only need the registration activity.java and the XML file. So we'll be dealing with only these two things today. All right. So what we'll be doing today is when I click on this image view, it is going to open up my gallery and it'll give you the option of choosing an image. So once the image is clicked, the image will be displayed here, and on click of the register button, the image is going to be sent on to the storage. What kind of data can we send to storage, right? So that'll be your next question. So you can send in images, audio, video, and also documents. So if you're asking me what kinds of extensions are supported, so Firebase pretty much supports all of the extensions now. They were covering each extension with new versions. So now it supports all kinds of versions. So if you're asking for the specific one, so in image you can have PNG, JPEG, JPG, and audio you can have MP3, MPEG, and for documents it supports your Word document files and also PDFs, and for video it covers MP4. All right. So these are kinds of data that you can send to Firebase. And next thing is, am I gonna be teaching you all that? So I'll definitely be teaching you how you can deal with different kinds of data and how you can send them. But the demonstration will only show you how you can send the image. All right, because that is what is the functionality of my app here. So I'll not need all the other things. Okay. So based on your application, you can modify it to whatever you want. All right. So before we begin with any of the things in Android Studio, so firstly we'll need to go to Firebase website and configure the storage. So I've already started my storage, so that's why I'm seeing this, but I'll just open up another project that I'm running so that you will see exactly what will be present when you first click on storage. So when you click on storage, this is what you'll be seeing. So just click on get started and it will say that the default rules are only allows the authenticated users to send in data. Just click on got it and it will open up this page here. So this is the link to your storage. So the storage is nothing but like a cloud storage. So this cloud basically hosts all your data, and all of this data is hosted as a URL. So when I click on that URL, you can actually download it as well. Okay, so that's how it works. So it says that default security rules requires users to be authenticated. So right now we'll keep all of this to public, like we have been doing it for the database as well. Later on, when the entire app is gonna integrate and work as one, so that time we'll make sure that everything is authenticated. Alright, so right now let's make this public. So go to rules, everything is pretty much the same as we did in database, however it has its own syntax here. So to make it public, you just need to remove this line. So just remove this and only up to the semicolon. All right, and click on publish. So if you're asking me how do I know what to put in here and how do I know that this is public, okay, so that is because I've referred the documentation, obviously. So if you go to their documentation, it says that there are four different types. So you can have for public, it is just allow read write. And if you want only specific users, so you can do that as well by using the unique UID, and you can also make it private. Okay, so these are the four options available. So I've seen that, and based on that, I'm doing that here. Okay, so nothing too complex, that simple. Okay, so everything is public right now. So everything is configured here. So the next thing that you need to do is add in the dependency in Android Studio. So open up the build.gradle file and make sure that this is in the app level module. So here I'm just gonna copy this line of code, and after pasting this, just change database to storage. Alright, So if you see here, Android Studio is saying that a newer version of Firebase is also available. So new versions of Firebase keep coming all the time, so you can update it if you want. So I'm just gonna keep it the same. Alright, so you can update it as well, so no issues there. Alright, so once you have added this and changed that, so you can just click on sync now. So until the Gradle build syncs, so the next thing that we'll need to do is, before we actually do anything, we need to check if our project is connected to the storage section of Firebase. Okay, so for that, once the Gradle build has run completely, you can go over to tools, click on Firebase, and you can check if it is connected to Firebase. So as you can see, all the different options that Firebase provides, all of them are listed here. So if you click on authentication, you can see that I'm connected to, so it will open a page as well, just close that. And here, yeah, just click on email and this thing, so it shows that this is connected to Firebase and all the dependencies are set up clearly. So we need to do the same for storage as well. So I'm just gonna click on storage, again close the tab that it opens, and you know, click on upload and download. So it says that it is connected and the dependencies have been set up correctly. So in case you are not connected to Firebase here, so it will show a button saying that connect to Firebase. So this happens when you are not logged on into your Google account. So just click on this button and it will prompt you to just enter the credentials for your Gmail account, and once you're done that, it will say that you're connected. Okay, so once all of this is done, so we can go back to coding. Alright, so even the Gradle build has finished, so you can close the app level Gradle file. And here we have already defined the variable for the image view as user profile pic, and we have also assigned the ID in setup UI views. Alright, so the first thing that we need to do is add in the Firebase storage object. So we have created the object for that, and as we have been doing for every other thing, we need to get an instance. So Firebase storage is equal to capital F Firebase storage dot get instance. So once we have created this, we can go ahead and create the storage reference object. So storage reference is equal to Firebase storage dot get reference. Okay, so this is similar to the database reference that we had created for the database aspect of Firebase. So this is similar to that with the reference as the root object. Okay, so this basically specifies where the data will be stored, under what parent it will be stored. So if you do not give anything here, so it is just gonna put it into the main root folder. So once you have created this, so we can also have as many storage references as we want. So you can have one more called maybe myref1 or something like that. So storage reference, so using this root object, so this basically points to the root, right? So you can add in a child for that main parent, and you can call it maybe users, but in our case, like we did for database, so we'll obviously want the Firebase auth, so not this, the small f1. So Firebase auth dot get UUID. Okay, because we want to store the data corresponding to each user, but as you can see here, it says that UID might be null because this is the registration activity. So the user is just trying to register and we are not even logged on to Firebase. So obviously there is no UID present and it is gonna throw an error. Okay, so that is why this thing needs to be put inside the create user with this, with email and password, because here is when the user is actually created. Alright, so we'll be adding this later, but I'm just you know, telling you the different things that you can do with this reference. So here, after the child is defined, you can have a get parent as well for the child, so it will give you the parent of this child, and also you can have a get root. So in case you are lost in the hierarchy, you can just do a get root and it will point to the bottommost parent, so the main parent, which is nothing but the storage reference. Okay, so these are the different things that you can do. So I'm just going to remove this because we do not need this now, we'll add in this later. So before we actually even put anything onto the database, as I told you, we need to implement an image picker, right? So when I click on this, it should go to my gallery and pick an image. So we'll be doing that first and then we'll come back to the storage. So how do you implement that? So we need to implement that in imageView.onClickListener, right? So the imageView variable is user profile pic. So let me just inside onCreate, I'll just type in user profile pic dot set onClickListener, new onClickListener, and it will auto generate these lines of code for me. So here, once the image view is clicked, so it should start a new intent, an intent to basically take me to the gallery activity. So intent is equal to new intent, and we need to set the type. So the type is nothing but image, so it should be a string, so image slash star. Okay, so since we are choosing an image, I'm just putting image slash star. However, if you want to choose maybe a document file, so you need to do application slash pdf. If you want to do a doc file, you can do application slash doc. If you want all kinds of application, you can just put a star. Alright, so that is for documents, and for audio you can just do audio slash mp3, and if you want to just make sure it supports all file types, you can just do a star. Okay, so this is basically telling us what kind of data is being sent. So next, intent dot set action. So the action is nothing but action intent, not airplane mode change. You need to do a get content. So there are different kinds of actions which are predefined for this intent. So I'll just show you what are different things available. So you can check if battery is low, you can check app info. So these are the things that you know you could do. So I'm just gonna do get content because that is the intent used for getting content. Okay, as simple as that. Okay, and after this we'll be doing start activity for result. Okay, so start activity for result, I'll explain the how the function works in a while. So intent dot create chooser, and inside this we need to specify the intent as first parameter, and second parameter is nothing but a title. So I'm just gonna put select image, and the final parameter, which is outside the brackets, outside the inner brackets I mean, and we just say pick image. Okay, it's gonna throw an error because you're not defined this. So just go ahead to the top and call this private static int pick image, and we'll give this a code of 123. Okay, so you can give this any code. I'll tell you why we are doing that, because start activity for result is basically a function which takes a request code and it checks if the request is successful or not. Okay, so based on the request, so if it is successful, then only the intent, you know, gets executed and the control is given back and forth. Okay, so that's what start activity for result does. So let's create that function here. So since it's an override function, you can just do alt 0, and if an umlock is on, make sure you switch it off and then try it again. So you should get this dialog box, click on override methods and type on activity. There's no search bar, so just go ahead and type it on your keyboard and you should see this on activity result. So click on OK and this function gets created. So it got created above on create. Alright, anyways, so here it has three parameters. Okay, so it has request code, result code and the data. So what this result code does is it checks if whatever functionality that you're implementing has executed successfully. Okay, so you'll see that here. So if request code is equal to pick image, so that is the variable that we had created, and also, so this is a boolean and, so double and also result code is equal to result, okay, all in caps, and the third parameter is we need to check if the data is null or not. Okay, so once you click on your image, so if it's successful, obviously there should be some data in it. If it's not, so that means there was some failure. So data dot get data not equal to null. Okay, it should not be equal to null. And inside this, so once I have retrieved the data, we need to actually, you know, put it inside the image view, right? So we need to create a path URI. So I'm just gonna create it here. So URI, so make sure that US capital RI, because there are two different things here. So there is capital URI and there is a capital U and small RI. Okay, so this is the unique resource identifier that we need. So I'm just going to call it image path, and here we'll assign image path to data dot get data. And before we actually put it on, before we actually set it to image view, we need to convert this into something which can be actually put into the image view, because right now the data is in the form of a path. So right now you need to convert it into a bitmap form which the image view can process. So for that we'll create a bitmap. So type in media store dot images dot media dot get bitmap, and inside this will pass the image path. Okay, so this will basically convert the image into a form which the image view can process. Okay, it's showing an error. Oh, okay, so the first parameter is a content resolver, so we need go ahead and add the content resolver as well. Okay, so this is an inbuilt function, so you need not worry about that. So get content resolver comma second parameter will be the image path. Okay, so this is obviously gonna throw an error saying that you need to handle the exception, IO exception. So IO exception is when something gets clicked and suppose there is some failure here, so we need to catch that error. So for that sake we can just surround this with a try and catch. So click on this red bulb here and click on surround with try catch block. So now the error has gone. So once the bitmap has been retrieved, we need to set the bitmap to the image view. So the image view is nothing but the user profile pic dot set image bitmap, and inside this we'll pass in the parameter bitmap. Okay, so we have set the user profile pic. So you can actually go ahead and run the app to check if this is working for you. So anyway, I'll be running this at the end because I want to complete the entire thing and don't want to drag this video. Alright, so we have completed this. So the next thing that we need to do is, you know, when the register button is clicked, that's when the data has to be sent, right? So here in registration, so I'm just gonna close close validate. Okay, in validate, so what we need to do is when the registration button is clicked, so you need to validate if the image has been selected or not. So for that you can just add in another or, and you can just check if the image path is not equal to null, is equal to null, because this is the error part of it. Yeah, so if it is equal to null, you just need to display a toast saying please enter all the details. All right, so even the validate is done, so I'll just go ahead and close that as well, and we'll not be implementing email verification, so I'll close that as well. So here when the registration button is clicked, so the Firebase auth.createUser with email and password is called. So the user is created and we'll be calling the send user data. So let me just add in all the functionality inside this function itself. So when the send user data is called, so you know, why not just send in the image as well. Okay, here itself. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is add the storage reference. So I'm just going to call it as image reference is equal to storage reference that we had already created. Okay, so it's not showing up here, so I think I've added it under onCreate, so it should be declared global. So under onCreate, so we had created the storage reference. So I'm just going to make this global by adding the main class outside. So outside everything but inside the public class, so just add in private storage reference. So this storage reference is nothing but the main root file, so it points to the main root file, and all other references which you create, you know, can have a reference to this and create a child attached to this. Okay, so that's how we'll be doing that. So here we have the storage reference dot child. So this basically means that we are attaching a child to the main parent, and we'll give this the parameter of Firebase auth.getuid. Okay, so this is nothing but creating a folder. So what I basically want is a folder for each user wherein all the details of the user is stored. So it can be either images, audio, video, anything. So for each user, under each user we'll also have another child, and you know, you can have as many references. So you can create an audio reference, you can create a video reference as well, and this remains the same. However, under the second child you can have maybe images, okay, something like that. So under images, so this is nothing but, see, you will have a folder created with the UID name, and this basically is the name of the file that are uploading, okay. So it should not be images, so it should be under images, but it should have the name as, you know, profile pic, okay. So here it is slightly different than your database reference. So in database reference it is nothing but the location where you want the file. So here it is similar, however that here you define where exactly the file is, and as well as what the name of the file which you upload also will be, okay. So these two, you know, the last child basically means the name of the file, okay, and you know, the first two, the child whatever you have created, so it will basically be in this format. So I'll just show it here. So you'll have a unique user ID. So user ID slash images slash profile pic. So it will be profile pic. You just underscore dot png or jpg, whatever your file name is, okay. So it will be in this format. So you can also have audio, you can also have video, okay. So hope everything is clear. And once you have created the reference as to where the file should be, so next thing you need to upload. So for uploading we have a class provided by storage. So as you can see here, it shows the main class, the storage, so it's provided in that dependency itself. So upload task, create an object for that, and it takes the image reference. So it, you need to specify where the file should be put, and put file, and the parameter it takes is a URI. So the URI that we have defined is the image path. So this is how you code. So when you just keep the cursor, Android Studio will prompt you for what the parameters are, and just put in all the parameters, and it's as simple as that, okay. So upload task dot, you can have an on, so it shows you the different options available. So you can have a on, add on failure listener, and insert this again on failure listener, auto complete, use that feature, and again add a dot, add on success as well, okay, success listener, okay. We have added the two listeners. So this is similar to what we have been doing previously. So we used to do add on complete listener. So in the on complete listener we had the task.isSuccessful. This is similar to that, except that these two things are provided you know, directly. So you can just have add on failure listener and an on success listener. So I'm just gonna add a toast message here. I'm just gonna copy this toast from the previous lines of code. I'm just gonna copy that and make my work easier. So I'm just gonna paste it under success as well as under failure, okay. So here under failure I'm just gonna say file upload failed, or maybe I'll just say upload failed, and under success I'm just gonna say upload successful. So we are done with the code. So before we go ahead and run, I'm just gonna explain what we had done here under on activity results. So I just think it needs some time to understand. So here we have just added an if condition, and the result code is the pic, request code is pic image, okay. So in the activity, so you can have as many request codes as possible. So you can have an intent set up for audio, you can set an intent for video as well, and just give it a unique you know, request code. So you can create a pic audio, pic video, and give it a different request code, and just do the in the same function. So in the same function on activity results, so you can have another else if to check for pic audio as well. So you can do that, and result code will be the same. Result okay is nothing but it basically tells if the result of the function was successful or not. And data.getData is basically, it'll get the image or the audio, whatever it is that you are executing. Alright. So once the image has been retrieved, so you just pass it on to the URI, and that URI is basically converted into a bitmap which can be processed by the image view. So that's why we have been doing that, and since it can throw an exception, some images may not be supported and all that. So that's why we need to surround it with a try and catch block. That's what we have done here, and I guess we have completed all this functionality in hardly 15 or 20 lines of code. So I guess this was simple enough. So I can just go ahead and run the app now and check if everything is working fine. Okay, so I have the app running here. So before you run the app, so go to your settings, app info, and delete all the cache data which exists. And also you can go ahead and delete all the existing users that you had created in authentication, because every part that you see, we are creating new users, and if you enter the same email ID, it's gonna throw an error. Okay, so I'm just gonna create I'm just gonna click on the image view, and I'm just gonna select the first picture. So it's the logo of Angular, so I'm just gonna call this maybe Angular, and angular123@gmail.com. And the password is 12345678, and the age is 21. Okay, so we have created a user, angular123@gmail.com. Click on register. Let's see if everything works fine. So as I told you, the other toast, it worked. So it said upload successful as well. Okay, so now we can check if the file has come on our Firebase website. So it might take some time. So go ahead and refresh the page, because it's not as fast as the database. So in database, all the data is actually real time, so you can get the real time, get all the data in real time. And so here, as you can see, we have the folder created for every user. So this is the unique ID of the user, and when I click on this, it should have a folder called images. Yeah, so I have, so here if I had created the references for audio, video, etc., so you'll have four different folders here for one user. Okay, so and when I click on this, so as you can see, it will display the image. So if you click on the image, you can see the image here. So it is the logo of Angular, and it also tells the size and also the type as image/png. okay, so the name is profile pic, as we had mentioned in the app. So right now we have created one user. Let me just create another user so that you can see that different folders are created. So I'm just gonna click on my picture here. I look good. Okay, so you can follow me on Instagram. So all the, if you are bored with technical stuff, you can follow me for some fun stuff there at Dheeraj Kamath. So the link will be at the end of the video, so, and also in the description. So I'm just gonna enter my details. So maybe I'll call stud. So stud@gmail.com maybe. I don't want comments on this, please. Okay, so click on register. So let's see if another user gets created. So upload was successful. So let's refresh the page. So as you can see, the upload successful, takes some time to pop up. So that means that since the data is larger than just string, so it takes some time. So that's why the upload successful comes a while later. All right, so as you can see, a new user has been created here. Let me just click on images, and let's see if the image is different or not. Okay, so I had created a different image, I selected a different image. So as you can see, my cool looking DP is here. So I guess everything is working fine, guys. So if you face any errors, make sure you put it down in the comment section below. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Also, do not forget to subscribe so that you do not miss out on any of my future videos. We are so close to 5000 subs, guys. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and help me reach the 5000 subs. It'll help me to create more videos, encourage me a lot. And in the next video, I'll be showing you how you can retrieve the data from the database. So catch you guys in the next video. Thank you guys for watching. Happy learning.